We need registers to collect and combine information about the business processes of our organization. For example, we collect information about sales or about products left in stock. One may describe the work of the register with the following scheme. Indeed, a document makes updates in a register. Yeah. And the register provides information to form a report. The register stores all relevant information and offers end-to-end access to this data. The register stores some numerical information broken down by some data. Now, that broken down by some data usually means that detailed information is provided for each type. For example, the report contains a list of customers, and for each customer, it includes the list of goods sold to that customer. And that is the report on the goods broken down by customers. The structure of a register consists of two things. Dimensions, the types of data by which the numerical information is broken, and resources, the numerical data itself. For example, the number of the product left in stock on a specific date. Consider we need to take into account the debt of our company to vendors and customers. For this purpose, we create a register debt. And to do it, we choose an accumulation register and add a new one with a proper name. After that, we need to add its dimensions and resources. Let's call it contractor of catalog ref dot contractors. In the same way, we add a resource total of number type. We need to select the documents that would update the register's data, because both these documents can change the debt of our organization. According to our contractor's actions, different documents will be posted. And because of these documents, our company debt will increase or decrease.